Today we welcome into studio Dr. Dietana Nemudzivhadi. She is Chief Director at the Gauteng Veterinary Services. Doctor, thank you so much for coming in to speak to us. Lovely to have you. We were having a very interesting discussion off air about the issue of rabies. And we understand Gauteng is under control, but my understanding is surrounding areas have not managed to bring this under control fully.
Well, it is true. We have the disease under control within Gauteng, although we do now and again have dog cases like we had recently in Harankua, but it was only dog cases. And when compared to the other areas or other provinces, the biggest challenge is that you have human cases. And, you know, that brings the level of seriousness to, you know, a whole new level altogether. Because once you have human cases, it shows you that you have a highly, naive or non-immune dog population, because it's usually transmitted by dogs, dogs to humans. Yeah.
So you're in the middle of what has been an ongoing campaign. I know that we've had various discussions with officials from your department in the past, and you've done your best to clamp down on this. Can you tell us about some of the projects you've introduced in this regard?
Well, as part of our annual plans, rabies campaigns, vaccination campaigns in townships, informal settlement, and farms. It's actually part of our ongoing activities, for this very reason that in order to control rabies in the pet population, you've got to try and vaccinate about 70% of the dog population. But as far as we're concerned, our coverage would seem to be, you know, wide enough to prevent, especially spillage into the human population. So vaccination campaigns are scheduled, you know, throughout the year. With extra effort placed in September month, because it's World Rabies Month, and that culminates on World Rabies Day, which is the 28th of September every single year.
If someone is bitten, for example, by a rabid dog, and you find out about it early, there can be an intervention made in order to save that person's life.
Absolutely, absolutely. And that golden period is 24 to 72 hours. The sooner the better. Although I need to mention that the success of the prophylactic treatment depends a lot also on where the bite is.
You told me about a very sad case earlier involving a two-year-old child, and that interestingly was a transmission of rabies not from a bite but from a scratch.
Very, very important. I think a lot of people only think of rabies transmission happening through bites. There's different ways of exposure. It could be a lick on an open wound, a scratch. It could be, because remember, it's carried in the saliva of that animal. That is why when, for example, we are removing a brain specimen for testing to the lab, we always wear full protective gear, because the risk of exposure is very high.
So tell me what sort of symptoms you're looking out for if you suspect a child or even an adult or an older person might have been infected with rabies.
What happens is that around the wound, there are reports of itchiness, excessive itchiness around the wound, but also because it affects other nervous tissue, there's difficulty in swallowing. Where you find that the person cannot swallow, and therefore, the saliva just drools. And because of that, they develop what is called hydrophobia, the fear of water, and, they get agitated. They've got this, very unusual stare, in their eyes. And, as the disease progresses, they become comatose and die. It's a horrific, horrific, scene to witness.
You've spoken as well about some the anomalies that sometimes occur here. So you may have large members of the community turning out to get their animals vaccinated, and then you may have one member of the community who, for whatever reason, is unable to have his dog vaccinated. What are sometimes the consequences of that? Just a single person not participating for some reason.
You see, the moment we become aware that this is a suspect rabies case, the veterinarian that is responsible for that area has to pay a visit to that household you know, observe the animal, and the first thing they will ask is, where is your vaccination certificate? Yeah. If it's not vaccinated, it's a non-negotiable, we have to euthanize the pet, yes, immediately, because they are human beings at risk.
Doctor, so good talking to you. I've done 100 rabies interviews, I think, in my career, but I don't think the whole idea around immunization and so forth has been opened up to me so eloquently as you have today. So I've really appreciated your time. Thank you so much for coming in to speak to us today. That was Dr. Dietana Nemudzivhadi. She is Chief Director at the Gauteng Veterinary Service.